私は知識科学の学系長をしています、幸田と言います。My name is Yoshi Koda. I'm a Dean of School of Data Science. なんで、で、今日は、本先生の最終講義をこれからいたします。Today, it's a time for 本先生 's final, not defense, final lecture. And then, 本先生は20年間、20 years,知識科学系の教育研究に貢献していただきました。僕らさんと5年間聞いてますので、トータルで25年間、メンタル系の研究教育に貢献していただきました。He has contributed to our JICES for 25 years. So I think that is very great contribution to us. その非常な貢献は非常に、大きいと考えます。で今日はぜひ高先生の最終講義を楽しんでいただきたい。今日は私のですね。まずぜひ、Let's enjoy 高先生の final lecture. So, I'm very looking forward to that. じゃあ、よろしくお願いします。
Thank you very much.I choose the title as is a change of machine learning I focus on machine learning but one could say machine learning changed quite a lot and what we have done during the change of machine learning in my time at JICES. So firstly I want to explain a little bitI take the title. At first, I choose title of my 35 years with the machine learning. But does it mean I was a high school student and then started to learn applied mathematics in Hanoi University of Technology? And then it was interrupted by military service for 3 years, and I go back to.And study in applied mathematics in Hanoi University of Technology. And I graduated by the end of 1978 and joined the Institute of Information Technology of Vietnamese Academy of Science Technology. And then I had the scholarship to go to France for my master and PhD. And since that time, I started to work on machine learning. And until this March of this year, it is about 35 years I ongoing with machine learning, and I have interest 25 years. 5 years, first 5 years in the School of Information Science, and then after that, the Knowledge of Science School was established, and I moved to that school with a task working on data mining. And Knowledge of Science School working on how to create and to use the knowledge. And one way is how knowledge is created by machine, created and used by machine, which is the starting point of our school. So in that, in this lecture, I want to address several things. First is how machine learning has evolved in the last 35 years or 40 years, etc. And in this, and other thing is how machine learning and other related area. In that period, I want to say also how is our research and education in the change of machine learning. And just being machine learning is not fixed. It changed quite a lot in the last 30, 40 years. And of course, the last part I will talk about Japan, China, and Vietnam. And the second part about, the third part about research education, I will mix some of them in the change of machine learning and in the relation to other fields. So I started by sharing with you how machine learning has changed. I choose the way to present something. We hope it is essential, but not go to very detail, so that the most people can catch the change of this, I think, important area. Looking back to the time when I started my master course in Paris, at that time, it was the boom of artificial intelligence called AI. And at that time, when the expert system in early days of AI is something like deep learning. Right now, people talk much about deep learning now. Even at that time, people talk much about expert system and consider it is the way to achieve AI. What is an expert system? It is a computer system that can make decision and act as a human expert in some specific field. We have today Takabe Sensei. We work together many years. Takabe Sensei is a professor in medicine from Chiba University Hospital. And he's a medical expert. He gives many advice on how to diagnose and give a treatment for the patient. But if we can make a system that can have ability like Takabe Sensei, people hope to make 1,000 copies, 10,000 copies sent to every hospital, and they can use such a system to deal with the patient. So this is a dream of early day of AI. And this system, how to do this? People need to take the expert knowledge to represent in some way and to put in computer in a very good knowledge base and use the knowledge base when meet the patient or special day to give the diagnosis or treatment like the experts do it. So many systems at that time in the years of 80, typical medicine is the myosin system that's the deal for infection diagnosis. And in many other areas, people also make the expert system in the same way. However, after a long period, it doesn't work. And the key problem is the knowledge acquisition. It is very difficult to take the human knowledge to put on computer. And this is the main obstacle. And this leads to some consequences. In that time, Japan is a zero war international competition between the US, the UK, Japan, and many European countries. And in Japan, we start the fifth generation of computer system. And say fifth generation means they have first, second, third, fourth generation. And that's a project due for 10 years from 82 to 92. And the purpose of that is to make a parallel computer that can behave as a human with the knowledge of the code parallel and inference machine. And I came to Charleston in 1993. My first office is in the center right now, in the great computer room, but next to that, and in the room, we have a PIM machine, very big machine in the whole room. And that's in 50, I don't remember exactly, 55 or more. And Kunifuzi Sensei and many other professors use it to do. However, and that's the machine, the program is a set of axiom. And computation is to prove the statement from axiom. You know that at that moment, logic programming is a key technology. Somewhat unfortunately, the project gave a big influence to the research community, but some target cannot be reached. And the reason is, as we say, one key reason is the bottleneck is the knowledge acquisition. And from that time, there's some structure in the research of AI. This is the way of, I just mentioned, of expert system. It is it's a way of deduction. People put human knowledge on computer. That means to put general rule of principle on computer. And when they meet the specific case, the people use it to induce the conclusion, to make conclusion for specific case from general rule. It is a deduction. And of course, as we say, that's why does not work very well. And then that's leads to another way. At that time, it is an induction. That means going from many specific cases to general rule and principle, go from data to knowledge. In particular, for example, we don't have expert knowledge, but if we have many electronic medical records, that's not everything happened to a patient at their hospitalization. And a huge amount of electronic medical records for EMR. And if we can use a computer to analyze this, we might arrive to many knowledge in medicine or as well in other fields. So this way, in fact, as you see later, it is a key way of machine learning. And at that time, I said, Motola Sensei, Motola Sensei at that time was the leader of a research group on machine learning at the Hitachi company. And then we met in Ichikai conference in Chambéry, France in 1993, and I had a chance to work with him from that day and the way to go from specific to general rule. And the machine learning can be viewed as the goal of machine learning is to build a computer system that can learn as a human learn. We learn, we go to university to learn. So we want to make the computer that can learn as us. It is a general goal of machine learning. To do that, the key way is to start using data. The input of the machine learning system is a set of many, many pair of x, y, y, I. And xi is a description of an object in some space, and yi it belongs to generally a discrete space or a continuous value. We call this a label. Xi, as I know here, as a vector for some description. For example, it could be an electronic medical record, is one xi, and yi can be the disease of the patient. Diagnosed by the medical doctor. If you have many, many of XI, YI, maybe million, even many million, and even more, we hope to analyze this, to do something. The final target is to, in terms of mathematics, is to find a function, distribution, Px given, Py given X, or Px, depending on the data, have a label or not. The result, for example, to find that function, also equivalent like to give a diagnosis for the patient, or to give some, suggest some treatment regimen for a patient. So this is the picture of machine learning, see like this. And then machine learning has been changed and developed very fast in last, mostly for 40 years so far. It has a root in very early days. Give them say the machine, computer has around that time and at that moment, artificial AI as well as machine learning was in the period of enthusiasm. People hope to do many, many things in very short time. And in terms of machine learning, at that time, something like mass discovery, rote learning, and it comes with the name of pattern recognition. But after that, in AI, people found it is not easy to do, and it is a drop time of machine learning, of AI, of many single computer science. But also in that moment, there appear many techniques of machine learning, like a neural network, genetic algorithm, experiment-based learning, phase-based learning, complex analysis, inductive project programming, as I just mentioned, very popular in Japan, etc. And the term supervised learning and supervised learning, reinforcement learning, three main directions in machine learning appear at that moment. And some conference like ICML, the key conference on machine learning, ECMA in Europe, and PDD about data mining appear at that moment. At that moment, if pattern recognition appears at that moment, mostly based on numerical data, at that moment when people focus mostly on symbolic data, binary categorical data. And what happened next? In that period, around from 90 to 2000, that's been around the time I start to work in CHEST until 2000, 2005, something. It is the period that data mining appeared, started in 1995, and something like the active online learning, semi-supervised learning, and some method structure, particularly statistical learning, at that time, mathematics and machine learning come to meet each other. In the early day, most methods here are heuristic, no mathematics in model. But to start from that period, mathematics, particularly statistics and machine learning merge to each other and make the many successful application. And since that moment, people pay much attention on machine learning in general. And also the revival of symbolic, non-symbolic learning, that combine numerical and symbolic data. Lately, I tell you, statistics must focus on numerical data at the beginning. Machine learning at the beginning focus on symbolic data. And when those feel much to each other, they treat both the kind of data. This is something important to know. And in last time, it is a kind of change. It develops very fast on machine learning. Many things can hurt like deep learning, dimension reduction, probabilistic graphical model, kernel method, etc., etc. Since 1997, Motoda Sensei and other two people started to form PAKDD. It is a Pacific Asia Conference on Knowledge Discovery and Data Mining. And it formed at the same time with the Europe country. And in 2009, Motoda Sensei, the Professor Zhi Huang, became last time to give talk. Also from ACMA, ACM Conference on Machine Learning, I also joined in that group from the early day, and we developed. So I could say this is a general picture of machine learning. It changed very fast, and you can see at that moment, some of the things changed. Now I go back to remind you some key feature of machine learning. First is to say supervised and unsupervised learning is two main branches of machine learning. Supervised learning is assuming we have a data, here's a cell, simplified cell. We have a data like this, and if we represent this table, for example, the first cell we have a color is a line, 1 degree and 1 tail. And if people now that this cell is a healthy, it has a label. And if we have a label, like say you have a label data, and the method to work on label data is called supervised learning. Otherwise, if you don't know about that label, if you just have a data, it is unlabeled data. And in that case, the technique is unsupervised learning. It divides into two main branches. And in between, we have reinforcement learning. Another thing to pay is about the complexity of the data